Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do another reading and hope you all are doing good. Welcome back to my channel and people who have joined me for the first time, thank you so much for joining. Let's see what is the message for you in this moment from the angels or from the universe. What you have to do is just close your eyes, take a deep breath in and breathe out. Relax yourself and ask yourself that what do you need to understand in this moment, whoever you believe in the universe or in the angel, you can ask what do you need to understand in this moment. When you feel comfortable, just open your eyes and you have to select from these three different sets. So you may get drawn to one single set or you may get drawn to multiple sets. Because this is a general reading, you may resonate, you may not resonate with the cards or with the messages. Take whatever is for you and leave the rest. So till the time you are selecting cards, I would like to express my gratitude to each one of you for all the love and support, for all the feedbacks. Thank you so much for everything. And thank you so much. Okay, because words are less to express my gratitude to everyone. Thank you for all the comments because I really love hearing that I can contribute or I am contributing to some extent in your life. Okay, thank you so much. Let's see what is the message. Before that, you have to select from first set is seaweed. Second set is white tea. Third set is lemongrass. Okay, so these are essential oils. You can select any one. So we will start with seaweed. Okay, people who have selected seaweed, probably they are shifting, the energy is shifting and energy is coming more towards the love, towards the frequency of love. For that, so seaweed, here the message is also somewhere, I feel the love you will be experiencing will be very deep. So here when I say the love part, it is not only love for romance, of course it can be one thing, but it is more to do with love as a frequency. So people who have selected this, it is something revolving around love. So whatever is happening in your life in this moment is bringing closer to yourself. You are coming closer and closer towards your true self, which is very loving, very compassionate, very soothing, very healing. So you are coming in that energy. Okay, let's see what is the message for you. Okay, so let your past go. I have selected one set from Secrets of Millennia Mind. Focus on your net worth. Surrender to setting limits. Write about your thoughts and feelings. Denial. Teacher. So let's see what is the message. So I will start with let your past go. It says the burden of carting your past around has made you weary. Dear one, it's time to set this burden down. Keep only the lessons and love and leave everything else behind. You don't want it or need it and it's now gone. So as I was saying that you are coming in your true self and you are coming in the vibration of love. So you all are shedding whatever was hindering your growth or hindering you to experience love. So you are in the process of letting go. And if somewhere you feel stuck in your life, you feel that something is not working, so just let your past go. It can be with regards to person, with regards to thoughts, emotions, feelings, beliefs, anything that is stopping you to grow. because a part of you is in denial. And it's completely fine because I'm seeing that maybe you are also dealing with energy of fear, and it's very opposite to love. So where there is fear, there is no love. Where there is love, there is no fear. So the more you are shedding and you are letting go of your past, the more you are ready to deal with your emotions, which a part of you is in denial. The more you do that, the more you will see that you are coming in the vibration of love. Though this is a card specifically I have selected for money, but here it says focus on your net worth. So here I also feel both, even if it is regards to finances or even if it is regards to your own net worth. So your own net worth comes from how you value yourself. Okay, because somewhere in the past, maybe you have not set limits. So now, if you have that energy of not setting limits, please surrender to setting limits. It says, it is healthy to set boundaries in relationship. Practice expressing your needs, and remember that no is a complete sentence. So when you start learning to say no, and you will have healthy boundaries, that will really help you to grow, that will really help you to come in your true self. In fact, it will help you to experience love in every relationship. So for some of you may be feeling, you are feeling little guilty about doing that. Please don't feel guilty when you are setting boundaries. Boundaries are very important. We are humans. You have to respect your human feelings. And if you are not respecting, it's very well that other people are also not respecting. So please respect your feelings, respect your boundaries, whether it is physical, emotional, even financial, how much you are helping somebody or how much you are contributing. You don't need to feel guilty, you don't need to feel bad if you are saying no or you are setting limits. Completely fine with that. Then setting limits with your physical also, who you allow to be physically in your space or whom you allow to touch you, is all up to you. You don't need to worry about what the other person will think, because the person who will really value you, the people who really love you or who understand you, will not feel bad if you set boundaries. Okay, so let your past go, set boundaries, then come out of denial. If you want, you can affirm this. I acknowledge my fear, but I replace it with insight of awareness. The more you come in the awareness, the more you acknowledge your fears, the more you let go of the denial, the more you will see things are moving in your favor. So maybe some of you, you may feel that things are not moving in your favor in this moment, but actually it is just somewhere it is answered prayers. So sometimes prayers are not answered the way we want. They are answered in the way it is required, because you do not know behind the scenes. So maybe the people whom you feel are the closest or are friends or are somebody important, maybe you don't know behind the scene what their intentions are. Maybe they are not actually friends, or the people who claim that they love you are not actually in that energy. So whatever the universe is trying to give you or make you understand is to do so that you can experience love. Okay, so just focus on that. Then they say, when I say, this is also about your finances. I don't know, somehow this time I have picked cards for finances. So if you want to improve your money, they say focus on your net worth. The true measure of wealth is net worth, not working income. To build net worth, you need to increase your income, your savings and your investment returns, and decrease your cost of living by simplifying your lifestyle. Okay, so you need to increase your net worth by simplifying your life. You need to let go whatever is not working for you, because The more you focus on increasing your income, savings or returns, the more you will see that you are coming in the vibration of abundance with regards to money. Okay, even if you have any thoughts, beliefs, ideas about money from the past, let go. Because again, if you want to increase your monetary or your career or anything to do with materialistic wealth, you need to let go of the past. Maybe in the past you have recovered some losses, maybe you have understood things in a different way. Now you have to let go. It's not required anymore. Then I asked ascended masters whom you can connect. So it says teacher, for me it is a little difficult to pronounce. It says Maha Kohan Regosthi. I hope I am pronouncing it right. I would like to read a bit from the book. So they say, this card is about learning and teaching. You have learned a lot from your experience and relationships. And now it's time to pass that knowledge to others. Your current situation is bringing you opportunities for spiritual growth, teaching you some important life lessons. As soon as you understand and accept these lessons, old patterns will drop away and be replaced by wonderful new experiences. So, additional message of this card is, this person or situation is bringing you important life lessons. Ask yourself, what is the blessing? What's the blessing that the situation has brought to me? Your life purpose involves teaching. Forgive a teacher from your past. You are urged to teach others. So, Maha Kohan, also known as Master Rekosi or the Divine Director, is regarded as a spiritual teacher whose student includes Saint Germain. He is very involved with the world government leaders, intuitively guiding them towards peaceful resolutions. Call upon Ascended Master Maha Kohan for help with esoteric learning, spiritual teaching or efforts towards world peace. So whatever you are learning, as I was saying, that you are coming in the vibration of love, probably you need to also teach to others, because when you learn something, you grow, you evolve, you come into your true power, and you will be doing that same thing or helping same thing for other people's or contributing in some other people's life. So you can do that in whatever way you can. Then you can pray to Archangel Michael. The prayer is, write about your thoughts and feelings. It's all about writing about your thoughts and feelings. It's very well possible, because as I said, that you are coming out of in your true self and you are shedding something from the past. And it says, let your past go, denial and setting limits, so that you can increase your self-worth, net worth. The point is, the more you write about your thoughts and feelings, you also vent. Venting is very important to create space for something better. It says, thank you for helping me tap into my God-given creativity and wisdom, so I clearly express myself and glean insights, blessings and healing. Okay, so writing will also help you to express your feelings in a better manner. It will help you to also open your throat chakra, I feel. Third, I feel, is maybe some of you can write, or through their writing they can teach. So you can share your thoughts, feelings, ideas through writing. We are now in a century where social media platform is very much available. So you can blog, you can even be on a YouTube channel or something that can help you. One is to share your feelings, thoughts, ideas, and also you will teach to others. So this is what I feel. If possible, work on your solar plexus and your heart chakra, because that is another thing is coming up. Yes, you don't need to feel guilty about setting boundaries. It's okay to set boundaries. It's okay to say no. Come out of this energy of denial, whatever you are denying. Accept, because denial comes because we are not ready to accept somewhere, whatever it was from the past. It can be your own self also whatever you did, if you feel something you did wrong in the past, so accept it. It's okay to accept something that that you did in the past, because whatever you did in the past is according to your awareness in that time and space. So don't feel guilty about it. Just come out of that energy. Focus on your net worth and write about your thoughts and feelings. You can pray the prayer that I mentioned. Then one of your life purpose is teaching, or you can help many people to teach. You can help many people by teaching, so that they can also come in their true power, their true self, and they can also raise the vibrations of love and let go of fear. So thank you so much, and all the best for your journey. We will meet in some other time and space. Let me know in the comment section how was the reading for you. Lots of love to you. Thank you so much. Bye. So next set of cards is white tea. Let's see what is the message for you. First thought coming to me is something to shift in your aura. So again, shift in your vibrations, shift in your energy. And that shift is very positive. It's leading to something bigger than you can think of. It's leading to something that you even have not dreamt of. You know, whatever your dreams are, it is leading to much bigger than that. So it may make sense to you in this moment, or it may not make sense to you in this moment, but it is worth it, because the ultimate results will be very, very good. Okay, so just hold on, just stay rooted, don't worry. During this moment, if you can do some grounding meditation, you can easily found on YouTube. That will really help you. Let's see what are the cards saying. Okay. Oh, this is so beautiful. I love the energy. So let's start from, okay, envy, associate with successful people, surrender stubbornness, romance angels are helping you, and this is from a different deck and it says Cupid, and find the blessings in your current situations. So I would like to start with envy. So I think in the last segment also I had picked a similar card in one of the reading, envy. So two things: either you are envious of somebody, or either you are facing some people in your space who are envious of you. This can be in your workplace, or this can be in your personal life with regards to your relationship. If you feel envious, you have to come out of that energy, because it's not working for you. As I was saying, the aura is shifting, the energy is shifting, and you are coming in the higher vibration again, because it's taking you towards something that you have not even dreamt of. Envious is a feeling which keeps you on the lower vibration, and if you are facing people who are envious of you, you have to understand that whatever they think, whatever they do, whatever they understand about your life is up to from their perspective, and according to their awareness. You don't need to be bothered about it, because the awareness level keeps on shifting. Once they shift, probably they will understand, or it's high time that you let go of them, because it's not working again. You can also affirm, I am same as everybody but with different challenges. So everybody have a different challenge. You have a different challenge. Other person or other people have different challenges. The more you let go of this envious feeling, because envious comes from that, also makes you feel that the other person has and I don't have. So suppose if it's a relationship, you may feel, if suppose you are also learning, or you want to get into a new partnership, or in an existing relationship you want to experience more love or more compassion or the bonding, and if you are envious of other person, you say that it's not enough for me. okay, and I am not in enough, you know. When you say this in the universe, it will never be enough, no matter what the person does for you. Similarly, if people are envious from you, again, no matter what you do for them, they will be envious. So it's very important if you can have little healthy boundaries with them and let go of them, because they will understand when they have to understand. Okay, then I feel surrender stubbornness. Maybe at times you become little stubborn with regards to your situations or with regards to people in your life, or with regards to even money, your belief, your ideas, which becomes also, it comes from ego. And see, we all have ego, but you have to understand, if you let your ego overpower you and you become stubborn, you will not grow. And I was saying, you want to go higher and higher in every area of your life, whether it is your relationships or whether it is your finances or your career. It says, if you are tensing up or taking a rigid stance about something, gently observe yourself and become more yielding. This will help you communicate more lovingly with others and yourself. See, it's very possible that envious energy makes you more stubborn, whether you are envious or whether other people are envious. So first is, let go of this, and then let go of this being stubborn. Because whatever you are facing in this situation or whatever is happening in this moment is taking you towards that what you have not dreamt of, as I was saying. So suppose maybe you are looking for a relationship. You have not even dreamt of that kind of relation is coming in your life, because Cupid card says, let me just read first. It says, we send great waves of love into your heart and mind, awakening your love for life itself. Your clear decision to accept and enjoy romance has triggered the reawakening. This reawakening, allow yourself to spontaneously celebrate love in all its glorious aspects. Right? So, and it has come with a prayer. Romance angels are helping you. This can't be a coincidence. So, Cupid with romance angel plus, it has come with Krishna. And Lord Krishna is an avatar in Indian mythology, if you have read about it, or you have listened, or you have any understanding. Then he is a god who has taken avatar on in India with regards to spread all about love. Okay, and three different set of cards having same message, is it can't be just a coincidence, right? So you have to find the blessings in your current situation. The more you are in gratitude about it, the more you will see yourself growing, the more you will see success in your life, the more you will see the bigger picture of life. Okay, let me just read from here, because I really love reading from books at times. It just gives you a different or a deeper perspective also. It says, every situation offers opportunities to grow and learn. When we curse a situation, we block its energy flow and things fester and grow worse. In contrast, as you recognize the blessings within your current situation, supportive and healing energy flows towards you. This card comes to you because there is unrecognized blessings within your current situation. It could be something that you have learned or gained. For example, recognize the blessing to accelerate the healing and manifestation that's trying to come to you. Then additional message, instead of worrying, pray and use positive affirmations. Know that everything is in divine and perfect order. This situation is resolving itself perfectly. You heal through the power of gratitude. Okay, so when you come out of the energy of stubbornness, you become little more flexible, you do more gratitude, automatically the energy will shift. Also, this tells me that you will associate, you have to associate yourself with successful people. Okay, see, this is specifically for money, but I feel this is also in our regular day-to-day life, that if we associate ourselves with successful people, whether they are successful in love, whether they are successful in career, whether they are successful in money, or they are successful in every area of life. So when you connect to like-minded people, you will also grow. It says, birds of feather flock together. The rich associate with successful people. The poor often associate with unsuccessful people. Energy is contagious. If you want to fly with eagles, you will have to stop swimming with the ducks. So if you want to go higher, and as I was saying that you may be going in the higher energy, if you see everybody is flying. So, you know, if you want to go in the higher energies, because abundance is always on the higher vibration, love is also is in the higher vibration. You have to see what is keeping you on the lower vibration. And you have to be in gratitude so that you automatically come in the higher frequency of love, abundance, or anything that you want in life. Also, let go of stubbornness. What you can pray? Romance angels are helping you. It says, dear guardian angels of my soulmate, thank you for preparing my soulmate and me for love, for giving us motivation to make helpful life changes, and for arranging us to meet. Thank you for helping us recognize each other and have the courage to say hello, so that we can eventually delve into truly intimate relationship. So you can pray this prayer. This will really help you to, you know, connect to like-minded people. It will help you to bring romance. You can do little bit changes with regards to love. If you are already in a relationship, you can ask, like here it is written, to meet the partner. You can write that whatever is needed to connect to your existing partner, so that, you know, it will help you to bring more love and romance in your life. This also says, some of you who are looking for relationship, let go of the stubbornness in a way where you have a very rigid idea about relationship. You need to let go of that. That will really help you. What else? If you believe in prayers, and if you believe in God, goddesses, you can also connect to Lord Krishna, who can help you to connect to that partner that you are looking for. If people who want to increase or want to, you know, have more financial growth in their life, again, associate with successful people, because the only difference between successful people and non-so-successful people is thought process, the way they think, because they also have 24 hours, you also have 24 hours, then what is different? So the more you associate, the more you grow. And in this, some cases, if you see, it's like a man holding a hand of a woman. So in some cases, when you come in contact with your partner, he or she will also really help you. If you are doubting that, will you find that kind of partnership who will support you in your life with regards to your whatever endeavors you want to work, projects or anything that you want to work. Will the person help you, he or she? You don't need to doubt, okay? The person will be very happy to be associated with you. So that is one of the signs that you may connect to a partner who is really appreciating you, to who you are and what you do and what you want to do in life. Because that's again a sign of successful people. They support each other. They never let or put other people down, okay? People put each other down only when they have envious feeling. So if you are looking for a partnership, it can be a big sign. See how your partner treats you and your ideas and your vision or anything that you want in life. No matter how bizarre it is, how odd it is, or how weird it is. If it is important for you, it will be important for the other person. Okay. So this is the message for people who have selected set 2. I hope this was helpful for you. Let me know in the comment section how was the reading. And we'll meet in some other time and space. Lots of love. Bye. Do subscribe the channel if you haven't. Thank you. Bye. Let's go to the next set of cards, which is lemongrass. The first message which I feel is something to do being helpful. Either you will be getting the help that you want, or either there will be some helpful people again. two things, like one is you being helpful to others and some is somebody helping you. So any two things can happen, and also of course universe helping you. So whatever you want, ask the universe. First message I feel is ask the universe to help you, or ask the universe to bring that helpful people in life. At the same time, in whatever way you can, keep helping people, because whatever you contribute, whatever you give, that will come back. Okay, so do not hesitate to ask for help from the universe or from the people around. That will really help you, especially when you are feeling little emotionally down. We all are also going through this situation, if you are listening to this video during this pandemic. So it's very well possible, you know, that we are all in this lockdown, so that we are feeling low or depressed, or maybe any other reason you are feeling like that. Ask for help. Either it can be friends, family, or either it can be universe, or it can be a professional help. Do not hesitate to take help, because only people who are successful take help. Okay, victims do not take help. If you want to be a winner, take help. Okay, and taking help is also a sign of strength. Okay, so that is one thing is coming to me. Okay, the first card is blessing in disguise, fertility, love. Okay, get support or create a team. Okay, surrender your desire to control people and have confidence. Just give me a moment. I don't know why I'm taking so much time, but I'm just connecting to the energy. So many messages are bombarded, you know, like so many things coming up. I just want to frame it in a way which it reaches to you in a right manner, or to the greatest possibly. Okay, so first thing is blessing in disguise. What appears to be a problem is actually part of your answered prayers. You will understand the reason behind your present situation as everything resolves. Trust in heaven's protection and infinite wisdom to answer your prayer in the best way. So whatever you feel is a problem right now, okay, it actually is an answered prayers. You do not need to worry, because sometimes whatever seems to be a problem is actually leading, again, is leading to something better, better situation, better people, better finances, better lifestyle, better, everything better, okay? And the more you understand the blessings behind it, you know, whatever it is, even if you don't understand, you are willing to understand, you will see that things will change in your favor. One of the reason is, you feel that low energy, or you feel that something is a problem or something is not working for you in any area of your life. Okay, it can be physical, emotional, health, or relationships, or career, or money. It can be other people also, because some people may be really worried about other people also in your space. So if suppose you are okay, but maybe your parents or siblings or spouse or friends or colleagues, anybody, you know, I don't know, somewhere, if you feel that they are in a problem, do not worry about them. Instead, you can use, or about self also, instead use the energy of love, because energy of love is very strong. We take it very lightly, and also I feel many of you are more into thinking than feeling. Okay, that is the reason I was getting these bombarded messages, because I feel that you have so much on your mind, but you are not understanding how to make it into practical reality, or how to let it happen in your space. Maybe it is for other people also. You know that somebody needs help, or somebody needs something, or can change something, but you don't know how to do it. I would suggest be in the energy of love. Sometimes being in the energy of love is also not saying or not doing anything for them. Yes, it sounds very different, or maybe sometimes it may sound that how can I not do anything about it? No, but you have to let them take their own path. Instead of saying or doing anything, walk with them if you can. Okay, and be in silence with them. Try and understand their point of view. Try and understand what they want to tell you. If it doesn't suit you or if it doesn't suit your energy, just take a step back. Okay, have boundaries. But if it is okay with you, then be there. Okay, because it's saying surrender your desire to control people. Being over controlling can sabotage relationship. To more effectively achieve your goals, back off, regroup, and give the situation some breathing room. So as I was saying, maybe you are too engrossed in this energy of where you feel what is the blessing in this situation, and you don't understand that. So first is let go of your control issues, because the more, so this control can be controlling other people, controlling your own life, controlling what universe has planned for you, or trying to understand or trying to make sense out of it every minute. Don't do that. It's a very self-sabotaging thing to do it. It's again, I feel some of you, this control issues may be coming when you had issues with one of your parent. If you are into healing, or even if you're not into healing, I would suggest start connecting to that inner child who wants everything to be certain, or who wants everything to be as per their liking. Maybe because other people have also demanded the same thing from you, which you are doing in return. Don't do that. Okay. Then they say get support or create a team. So this can be about your finances, and it can be literally about your life also. When you try and do everything on your own, it will be very burdened. You will feel very burdened. You cannot do everything on your own. If you see, people are helping each other to make a sign complete, you know, like dollar sign, right? So sometimes if it is finances, don't try and do everything on your own. If it is your life, don't try and do everything on your own. Ask support, take help, create a team. If it is your business, again, take help. Take professional help who can help you to understand more about yourself, who can understand about your business or about your plans. Okay, it says don't try and do it on your own. Find a good financial planner who can help you track and build your net worth by organizing your finances and introducing you to a variety of vehicles for saving and growing your money. Okay, then fertility. And now fertility can be literal for people who are planning to have children, or fertility can also be something to do with abundance, something to do with nurturing also, I feel, because it has come with the card love. So nurture yourself, okay? Connect to your own inner self, and the more you do that, the more you will see things falling in place. Okay, let's see literal meaning. He says this card signifies that it's a very fertile time for you. This is an ideal time for the conception of a baby or a new project. All of the doors are open for you right now. Your mind is fertile with many wonderful ideas, and abundance easily flow to you. Since everything is in infancy stage, have patience with growth process. Just nurture yourself and your project so that you stay strong and fertile. Additional message, you have the Midas touch and everything is turning to gold right now. There is good news about pregnancy or adoption. Let go of worries or guilt and enjoy yourself. Now is a good time to start a project. And the Ascended Master is Pan. Pan is an ancient Greek deity of nature, mirth, music and fertility. It was love at first sight for Pan when he spotted the lovely wood nymph Syrinx. Yet Syrinx didn't return his affection. It is said that Pan was unattractive, that his name became the root of the word panic, okay, word panic, because of the reaction children had when they saw him. So Pan ran after Syrinx down to the river. Syrinx called upon water nymph for help, and they returned Pan into willow reeds. As Pan yelled for help, the reeds made beautiful music. Later, when Pan transformed into his original self, he made a musical instrument of reeds, which is totally called a panpipe. Call upon Pan for help with fertility issues, music, or to relax and enjoy yourself. Okay, so maybe as you are going through a phase, connect to Pan, Ascended Master Pan, who can help you with music with regards to letting go of this situation, also letting go of control issues, also coming in your true power of love. And you, if you are having issues with fertility, again connect with Pan because he can help you with fertility also. It says you can affirm, I commit to practice of seeing good in all things. Again, same thing, blessing in disguise and seeing good in all things. Then it says, have confidence. Archangel Michael, please lend me your courage and fortitude. Help me realize that I am one with all the divine wisdom, strength, love, creativity, abundance and health. Allow me to feel confident and peaceful about myself in all ways. So maybe because, see, when you are coming in true power, when you are focusing on yourself, you let go of control issues, you take support, you will also have more confidence. And confidence will help you to bring the desired changes in your life. Okay? So again, if you want to work with chakras, then please work on your solar plexus, also your heart. Some of you also work with your root. Okay? Because somewhere, root I am saying because somewhere you feel scarcity of love or scarcity of opportunity or scarcity of help. I think some kind of scarcity, so that will really help you. Yes, regroup yourself, connect to like-minded people, take help, that will really help you. Okay, also be more indulgent in some kind of music. Soft music if possible, or music which soothes your energy or your soul. Okay, so even if you can be more regular with taking more of salt water bath, that can also help you, because maybe you are picking up other people's energy and that will really help you. So this is all I have for people who have selected lemongrass. Let me know in the comment section how was the reading for you. Lots of love. Thank you so much for being in my space. If you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel. We'll meet in some other time and space. Thank you. Bye.